अरे मैं आवाज नहीं ला रहा था, ऑन म्यूट करके बोले जा रहे थे।
मेरी आवाज नहीं आ रही क्या?
मैं ऑर्डर लेटर इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट दैट अप्रूव द बाइंग एंड सेलिंग ऑफ अ प्रोडक्ट एंड प्रेजेंट आइटम डिटेल्स लाइक मैम मैम इन ऑर्डर लेटर वी कैन ऑर्डर एनीथिंग टू द एनी कंपनी। देयर आर थ्री टाइप ऑफ ऑर्डर लेटर, फर्स्ट ऑर्डर जिसको हम लोग फर्स्ट ऑर्डर वाला ट्रायल ऑर्डर, सेकेंड ऑर्डर एंड द रिपीटेड ऑर्डर। मैम दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्डर एंड फर्स्ट ऑर्डर we get the sample
you
of
you
the
have discussed the order, the three types of order letters. One is the
first order trial order, this from look sample order, this
trial order
sample mang
all right
company.
First order is a trial order, the second
repeat order
yes
repeat
the
order.
Second order is the repeat order. Can you define what is the trial order? Explain. Supposing you are getting a question of write notes on trial orders, what will you write?
I mean trial order, we would take the sample of the product. We would take the sample of the product.
You are buying
the product
when you are buying a new product, or when you have something in your mind to taste something, to buy something, you will not order it in a bulk. But first you would like to be satisfied whether you are going to convert this trial order into a repeat order or not. First of all, you will place a trial order. And when you are satisfied, when you are getting things as expected, then you will place a repeat order. It means the same order is repeated. And when the repeat order converts into a routine order, when every time you want something of the same kind, you will order. It will be a routine order. It means things will be coming from that organization only or that place only. So trial order, repeat order and routine order. I think I gave you some assignments about letter writing, which nobody has shown me as yet. Yeah, somebody was raising his hand. Business letters, writing orders and complaints. Let us look at the terminology business letters. What are business letters? What are business letters? What are you thinking about? Define business letters.
Yes, ma'am. Can I define, ma'am?
A letter from one company to another company.
Yes, you can define.
Yes, ma'am. Business letter is a type of business which we can write in a formal form. And for example, if such an organization, for a customer, for a client, we write.
Yes. Anybody else define in a better way? Too much of time in answering the question. Can can business letter be written externally? What is the difference between business letter and official letter?
Business letter is a letter which is used for the business purpose, like manager to client, customer to client. This is a business letter. Official letter is a letter which is used in a office only, like a manager to the employee.
Okay, very good. So the business letters can be written internally and externally as well, because in business letters we are writing internally also. For example, I would like to take up classes for French. So I will put up a letter. I will put up a proposal. That is a business letter. But official letters can only be done officially, not externally, concerning with offices, official issues. So official letters can be done only internally, whereas business letters can be done internal as external as well. Do you understand? Somebody read the Hindi as it is in your manual. Yeah, who is reading? Anybody read? Alok Ranjan, padhiye aap.
Sorry for that, ma'am. I'm somewhere else. I'm right now. I'm not. I have not my note. Copy and a notebook.
But you can see the screen, can't you?
Okay, ma'am, I did.
Yeah. Okay, I'm reading. Chaliye, padhiye aap isko.
Ma'am, the Hindi part and the English part?
Yes, Hindi part.
पत्र लेखन एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण तथा जरूरी कला है। एक विभिन्न क्षेत्रों में इसका व्यापक इस्तेमाल होता है। इस अध्याय का उद्देश्य है छात्रों को विभिन्न प्रकार के बिजनेस लेटर लिखने की कला सिखाना, उन्हें बिजनेस लेटर लिखने के लिए वर्तमान में प्रचलित विभिन्न तरीकों फॉर्मेट से अवगत कराना। इस अध्याय के सफल समापन के पश्चात छात्र विभिन्न प्रकार के फॉर्मल लेटर लिखने में सक्षम हो जाएंगे।
सो दिस फॉर्मेट इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड टू स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट फॉर रेफरेंस। सो योर द बुक इन योर हैंड इज जस्ट फॉर रेफरेंस। यू कैन ऑलवेज रेफर, गेट बैक, clear your doubts after reading them, after going through your manual. First of all the topics and important points will be discussed and explained to the students. The students are advised to ask questions if they have any queries. Again, repeatedly this is being told, that you need to ask questions if you have queries, and you should have queries if they want more clarification on any particular point. Since the format of business letter remains almost the same, this will help you in understanding it easily. And you must note that the topic for the job or the question to write a letter may be different in examinations. However, all these will be written using the same format. What is the difference between formal and informal letters?
लेटर जो मैम हम लोग ऑफिस में लिखते हैं, और
फॉर्मल लेटर्स आर रिटन इन ऑफिसेस इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन व्हिच फॉलोज अ कंप्लीट फॉर्मेट, अ स्टाइल एंड अ स्ट्रक्चर। वेयर एज एन इनफॉर्मल लेटर, व्हेन वी आर राइटिंग टू आवर पेरेंट्स, व्हेन वी आर राइटिंग टू आवर रिलेटिव्स, फ्रेंड्स, And this is conversational English. You write the way you speak. So any kind of informal letters are conversational. And it does not follow any format, or it does not have any structure. Now business letters, as we discussed, business letters are written internal and external, in both ways, externally and internally. There can be internal business letters, there can be external business letters. So business letters are written on a company's letterhead, which includes the organization's full name, address, phone number and email address. The part of business letters are the date, attention, inside address, subject optional, salutation. Subject is not optional, one thing is there. Subject is never optional, subject has to be there. Date, your address first, then the date, then the reference or the attention line, inside address, probably you already know what is inside address, the recipient's address, and then subject, which is not optional, salutation, the body has three parts. Can anybody explain what are the three parts of a body in a letter, in a business letter? What are the three parts? The first paragraph, the second, and the third. In a business letter, what are the three parts of a body? All this was discussed in the first semester also. Yes, Komal, please say something. What you guys are doing very fast is forgetting. Whatever you learn, you forget. Yes, forgotten. The first paragraph is the introductory paragraph, wherein you state, you introduce yourself and you state why you are writing this letter, your introduction and the purpose. In the second paragraph you will write why and how you want the recipient to respond to you or to take action, or in other words, what do you want from the recipient. And the third part, politely, you with a firm, assertive confirmation and request, thanking the recipient and complimentary, closing it. So there are three parts of a letter. You all seem to be forgetting very soon. So complimentary close, signature, CC, copy rotation, or the you already know what is copy rotation, you know what is BCC, you know what is CC. All these are parts of a letter.
I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is enclosures?
Enclosures. Let me get my pen. What are enclosures in business letters? When you write a letter, you enclose. You write an application, and what are the things you attach? You attach files, you attach photographs, you can attach checks, you can attach your cover letter,
Yes, ma'am. So my additional documents.
Yeah, additional attachments.
Yes.
So after you close your letter, after the complimentary close, you will write ENCL, which means enclosures, and then you will write how many enclosures you have attached. If it is two, write two. If it is three, write three. If you have attached a check, only a check, you can write one. The enclosures are attachments. So as you already know, the business letter format. Some students confuse parts of a letter and format of a letter. Parts of a letter are quite different and format is quite different. Format means styles. So there are three business letter formats commonly used. The most commonly and the most popular is the block style. And there is no indention in this letter. All lines are written against the left hand margin. And this is the most popular style of writing. The second is the modified or the block style format. Modified block style format. The difference is just that you just write the date and your complimentary close was slightly towards the left. Right. So the difference between block style format and modified block style format is that the fact that date and complimentary closing are written slightly right to the center. And then there's the indented letter format, which is the olden style of writing. Some people still use it today. The semi-block style or the indented. Indented means in between. It starts in the left, but then the paragraph start 5 spaces from the left. In the semi-block style format or indented, everything looks very poetic kind. So these letter formats, the paragraph are indented 5-6 spaces from the left of the margin. The date line and complimentary closing are typed to the right of the page center. This we already have discussed, but then everything needs to be revised because you keep forgetting. Okay, let us move on. So this is the block style. Everything starts from the left. Date, your reference, our reference. So everything, the inside address, the recipient's address. Reference can be made. You can make up your own reference, your reference, whatever it can be. The company's initials, oblique, the name of the department, oblique. Number of the letter and inside addresses, the recipient's address and subject. Subject line is never optional and subject line has always got to be there, and you have to leave spaces, see, to separate subject line and then salutation. Dear sir, dear madam, dear Mr. Gupta, dear Mr. Sharma, whatever. And this is the body. As I said, the body of letter has three parts. The first, the introduction part, the introduction and the purpose why you're writing this letter. Second paragraph, what you want the recipient to do, how do you want him to respond or her to respond, what are your expectations from the recipient. And the last is, so some lines are there. If you need any help or assistance, please feel free to call me or whatever. And the last line, a small line like, we value your association with us, may be written here. Means you are closing the letter in a very polite manner. thanking the person once again in advance for whatever you want from the person, right? And then complimentary close, yours faithfully, yours sincerely. Faithfully, the students can write, but then yours sincerely is the most suitable. Yours truly, yours sincerely will do. So here the person has signed off as Jay Singh Sender, and he the designation is there and the company's name. I am Jay Singh, operation manager in company's name. So in your book it is very well defined and very well written, so you will not have any problems, but still you make problems, you create your own problem. For one reason, nobody has the time to open your books. You never even bother to see what is in the book. And these books are, as I said, helpful in more ways than one. So you need to look what is in the book. Had it been so, people would have got better results. And enclosures. Somebody asked me, enclosures kya hota hai? Enclosures, all your attachments. Kindly find the attached brochure, information, or check, or resume, or whatever. This is again, it is written, and you will write likewise. This time, don't make mistakes. We come straight away to order letters. An order is a formal document which places a demand for goods or services along with the details of the product or service required. It means it's a formal document. Orders are placed. It is a demand for whatever services you want or for whatever goods you want to order for, along with the details of the product. It means the details of the product, what do you want, how do you want, when do you want, everything has got to be there in your order letter. The address, where do you want this, the product to be delivered, everything has to be there in the order letter. Before placing an order, one must get all the details of what you want to buy. The details can be grouped under the following headings. Products, its specification and quantity. Specify which product you want and how many you want. Some products come in a variety of sizes, small, large, middle, different colors, different sizes, everything has to be defined. The exact product should be identified by specification like size of the product, the packing, color, catalog number, model number, unit price. This you can ask for and do the needful. You can write for the brochure, you can write for the catalog, and with the help of that catalog you can get the size, the color, the model number, the unit price, everything is there in the catalog. Mention the correct quantity required for and its purpose, unit of measurement. Different products are sold in different measures, liquids in liters, solids in kilograms, dozens or hundreds, and large products like cupboards in units. So before you make a good order, get the details from the company. So the first is products and its specification. Second is packing. Liquid and small products have packing of various quantities. Shampoos are packed in 100 ml, 200 ml, etc. While tablets come in strips of 10 or bottles of 50 or 100, etc. Some products are available in different types of packing like bottles, tins and sachets, which should be specified in the order. You have to write everything in the order, how you want your product to be delivered. And third is delivery. Give the full address at which the goods are to be delivered. If the order is urgent and you require the goods within a certain time frame, ensure that you give the date. The mode of transport need not be mentioned unless it is carried forward. Means give the exact date when you want the goods to be delivered. And number four is settlement of account. How you will mention how you are you going to pay this. Mention the agreed prices and terms and refer to a discount or concession given, mode of payment of the bill. I think that's it for today. Ways to place an order, we are going to do this in the next class. In the next class, please do your homework, do some reading and then come.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll take the attendance today. Roll number 2. 1 minute. Roll number 2, roll number 10. Roll number 3. 2, 3, 10. 49 and 29. That's it.